We're restoring the Bearcat back to flying condition. It was damaged in an engine failure after takeoff out at Oshkosh, I think in 1993. And we were able to acquire the thing about 12, 13 years ago. We got it in a badly damaged condition where the outer wing panels had been destroyed. And the left wing had broken the spar. The landing gear had been torn out of the left side. And the fuselage had a kink in it. We had rebuilt one prior. It was a wrecked airplane that the CAF had wrecked back in the 60s. And we rebuilt that airplane. Ended up selling it to Rod Lewis. And that is when this one came along. That's why we sold that one. We love that one too, but we love doing projects. And that's where it came from. So we've did all the work required, change the spar and change the landing gear. We had a lot of parts and help from some friends and did some trading. We were able to get all the parts. And the whole thing is a challenge because Bearcat parts are not easily found. A lot of the stuff we had to copy or acquire. But now we actually, through the years, have got a good collection of hydraulic parts and spare bits and pieces. But it's a beauty, and we're lucky to have it for sure. And just we're all anxious to get it flying. Well, the Bearcat came about right during World War II. As the war progresses, Japanese and Germans are all coming out. Everybody's coming out with these new airplanes, new technology. It kind of sparked interest to Leroy Grumman, a couple of his engineers. They went to England to inspect a Focke-Wulf 190 that had been captured. And they were pretty impressed by the technology, the jump in technology, and the performance the airplane had. So that sparked their group to get together and come up with a new design, latest, greatest idea. And that's where the Bearcat came about. Grumman built the Wildcat and the Hellcat and the Avenger and pretty successful airplanes in World War II. They have a lot of experience, an amazing manufacturing plant as well. The Hellcat had a manufacturing plant that cranked out 620 Hellcats per month out of one factory in Bethpage, New York. So they really had the know-how. So the Bearcat was the development of the Hellcat, so to speak, which was the development of the Wildcat. And they incorporated a bunch of new ideas. And new ideas consisted of building an airplane that was as light as could be, most horsepower available. Latest design aileron, which were flying tab ailerons. And the airplane was designed to be the fastest airplane as well as the best climbing airplane. Just looking at the way the gear works, it's very unique in the sense, here we've got an airplane that has a 2200 horsepower engine and a 12 foot 7 inch diameter propeller. So it needs really long legs to give it propeller clearance. But it's really reliable. It's a big, strong landing gear. Never had any operational issues with the landing gear. But like I say, when you look at it, you go, how does that work? The wings are stub wings, fold up. It's a manual lock and unlock, and then you manually swing the wing down back and forth. There's a hole in the bottom of the wing where there's a casting. You stick a bar in it, and it's got an indicator on top of the wing so you know when the wing is locked. The red line on the airplane is 425 knots indicated, which is like 0.72 Mach, but that style wing, we call the 23,000 series airfoil, which is kind of like a laminar wing, but it, by today's standards, has a pretty low Mach limit. Rare Bear racing around there at 500 miles an hour at Reno is really right about at near its critical Mach. And the critical Mach in that wing causes a shock wave that causes the nose to pitch down quite a bit, and a lot of elevator pressure to make the airplane turn. John Penny has some good stories about the let go at the start of the race and then go down the end of the straightaway, and they're indicating up around 410 to 420 knots, and at that altitude that's way up, and it's he was talking about a 100-pound pull on the stick to make that first couple pylons. So having flown all these different airplanes, the Hellcat, we used to call it a Buick, it's a great flying airplane. And the Corsair is a smooth airplane. You call it more like a Cadillac, But boy, when the Bearcat showed up, it's definitely a Maserati. I mean, that's the kind of jump in technology that airplane was. Mustangs are great and Thunderbolts are good and Lightnings, but the Bearcat is a special airplane. It's the last of the breed of propeller-driven fighters. Neil Armstrong, the first man on the moon, that was his favorite airplane. So we had a lot in common to talk about Bearcats when he came and visited us here several times. You always have a favorite, but then you get a lot of tied for second place. But for propeller airplanes, the Bearcat is the most impressive performing airplane. And as a young man, a young kid at Planes of Fame, we had a Bearcat back in the day. And I can remember when I was 12, 13 years old watching the thing fly. And so that's a lasting impression in my head, what I thought, how great the airplane was. And then, of course, I got to fly one finally. It was about 1975 or 1976. Harold Beale had a collection, two or three Bearcats, and he brought one to Chino to have some work done to it. And Jim and I were just slobbering all over this thing, and he let us fly it. So that was the start of it. And I probably got 300 or 400 hours in a Bearcat now, too. Flown a lot of different, seven or eight different ones, having rebuilt a couple. And Bob Pond was a really good friend of ours, and had the use of that airplane pretty much for about 2 years. And so we used it quite a bit. Because of how it was designed and how they spent the time to save weight, it's not like a Hellcat Grumman Ironworks, but it is within its design limitations. It's a really strong and reliable airplane. And we've gone through it and made all the repairs and exchanged parts. And it's just maybe just a few weeks away from being ready to fly.
If you liked this video, please subscribe and leave your questions or suggestions for our next video in the comments below.